Welcome to another episode of Hood Games. I'm your host, the 40-year-old gamer, and today I want to talk about the VRs, man. You know, lately I've been seeing a lot of videos that people been doing VRs, man, and you know, a lot of videos made me laugh. You know, videos been good, and you know, I recently picked up VRs, me and my kids, and I just want to talk about a couple of them today, man. One of them is called the Utopia. This is called the Utopia 360. Utopia 360, man. It's a VR that you can get for $20 at GameStop. And I'll show you what it looked like real quick. Let me open it real quick, show you what it looked like. Out this black box come with it. Looks like this. Utopia 360. Got the grip on the back, you know. Come in a little nice little plastic. But this is the one for, you know, this is cheap VR for you know, people that just want to experience VR. You know, they can go on YouTube and watch those 360 videos in 360, you know, and that's what my kids been doing. So, you know, it's a decent VR, man. It's a decent virtual reality glasses, man. But, you know, it's one of the cheapest. I do recommend if you haven't experienced VR, you just want to experience VR in 360, go get a pair of these Utopia 360 glasses from GameStop. Any GameStop, if I'm not mistaken. Next one I want to show is one of the VRs that my son picked up, and it's called the Samsung Gear VR, and it's a, you know, it's a pretty nice one too, man. Open it up and show y'all real quick. Comes like this, you know, comes in this white case, looks like this, you know, the back with a grip on it, like the other one, but this one is actually better. The Samsung Gear VR has more features, and, you know, it has more games and things of that nature, and, you know, it's a really good VR, you know, for anybody that hasn't experienced VR or just want to experience VR. I would say on a phone. Anybody that want to experience VR and don't mind doing it on their phone, go with the I would go with Samsung VR if you can afford. You know, it's a little bit more expensive than the Utopia VR. It's like I think it's like $100 or whatnot. But it's a really good VR headset. You know, it's one of the clearest. You know, I do recommend the Samsung Gear VR. The next VR, which is the last one I want to show you, is, let's see, I want to show you, which is my personal favorite, you know, which is actually all our personal favorite, me and my kids. It's the PlayStation VR bundle, the whole bundle. You know, it comes with the PSVR, comes with the glass or with the camera, comes with two motion controls and the headset. And I'll show y'all what it looks like as well. This is what the PlayStation VR looks like, you know, which is one of my personal favorite VRs because of the games, man. Mainly because of the games, you know. I always wanted to see games in VR back in the early 90s, you know, when they first started talking about they were going to do it. And basically, you know, Nintendo came out with one, and I had looked in it, and it was terrible. I put it this way, it was called the Virtual Boy, and to me, you know, personally, like, it was 3D, you know. Yeah, 3D was just red, but it wasn't great. You know, I didn't like it at all. you know, it was, to me, it was not real VR at all, you know. But, you know, it was getting there. You know, I always wanted to, you know, play games in VR, like actually thinking of, you know, how would I feel if I was inside of a video game, man? Like I'm actually inside the game, man. That to me would intense the gaming experience. And that's what made me go out and buy a PlayStation VR. And one of the games that I bought for it that I actually enjoy, and you know, I won't play it in 2D right now because it's too enjoyable in VR, man. And that is Resident Evil 7. Resident Evil 7 is a terrifying game, man. Terrifying. I'm talking about, it's like you're inside of a Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie, man. With some crazy ass people, man. It is a great game. I do. Hey, welcome back to Hood Games. 40-year-old gamer. And today I'm gonna play Resident Evil for y'all. You know, just to show y'all how dope this VR is for anybody that doesn't have a VR or anybody that don't know what a VR is. This is what I call a PSVR. This is my favorite VR, and let's just get right into it, man. Bathroom look disgusting. Straight up disgusting. Look at the toilet, man. What is that not to do? Oh shit, bitch. Bitch, I don't want you no more. You're crazy. No!
Leave me alone.
What the fuck are you stab me? You're supposed to be my girl and you're stabbing me? Woo! This bitch is scary. Get up, dude. Get up. Alright, man. What's up? Yeah, bitch. Oh, damn. Man. Anybody that gets PlayStation VR to pick up Resident Evil for the PlayStation VR, it is a fantastic game, man. I do recommend this VR game to anybody. This is the one I've been playing. And let me tell you, man, the experience is so intense that it's not even funny. Like, I jumped a couple times, man. Like, this game is out cold, man. And for anybody that don't think this is like Resident Evil, this is just like Resident Evil. It's just in first-person view, you know. But I do recommend anybody that has played Resident Evil or haven't played Resident Evil, go get Resident Evil for the PlayStation 4, man. You know, and get you a VR headset, man. And let me tell you, man, it's an experience like no other, man. Okay, thank y'all for watching. If you like the video, hit the subscribe button. And until next time, man, y'all too old to be playing video games.